Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Tonight, you are cordially invited to the Julie Andrews Show. With her special guest, Gene Kelly. And the new Christy Minstrels. Brought to you by your gas company. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Julie Andrews.
On a wonderful day like today, I defy any cloud to appear in the sky. Dare any raindrop to drop in my eye. On a wonderful day like today. When the moon is as big as a yellow balloon, even the crickets are chirping in tune. On a wonderful evening like this, on an evening like this, I could kiss everybody. I'm so full of love and goodwill. On an evening like this, I'd adore everybody to come and dine. The pleasure's mine, and I will pay the bill. May I take this occasion to say that the whole human race should go down on its knees, show that we are grateful for moments like these, for the world's in a wonderful way, on a wonderful day like today.
Hey, fellas, it's a wonderful day for umbrellas and parasols and bomber shoes.
May I take this occasion to say,
hear, hear,
that the whole human race should go down on its knees,
please,
show
on a rainy, rainy day. And if your sweetie cries, just tell her that a smile will always pay.
Whenever skies are gray, don't worry or fret, just let a smile be your umbrella, and you never get wet.
Just let a smile be your
come on.
kind of September when life was slow and oh so mellow. Try to remember the kind of September when grass was green and grain was yellow. Try to remember the kind of September when you were a tender and callow fellow. Try to remember, and if you remember, then tender, when no one wept except the willow. Try to remember when life was so tender that dreams were kept beside your pillow. Try to remember when life was so tender that love then follow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember, although you know the snow will follow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember without a the heart is hollow. Deep in December, it's nice to remember the fire of September that made us mellow. Deep in December, our heart should remember. Such a lovely song. Now, we have a great many more songs that we want to do for you tonight. We're going to sing some, and we're going to dance to some, whistle some, and maybe even hum some. All kinds of music. Folk music, for example. I have some friends that sing that better than anyone.
One little Christy plunking on a banjo. One little Christy plunking out a tune. One little Christy plunking on a banjo. But you know there'll be more soon. Here comes the bass and the fella who plays it, Clarence is his name. Must be a ton that it weighs. It sure seems a shame. Lump keeps the group steady, long fat strings just like spaghetti. Compact cars don't have much space to place a bass.
Christy minstrels, Christy folks, Christy minstrels, songs and jokes, happy folk tunes.
Minstrel gal, we bring glamour to the music.
three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Well, that's fine.
The lines were very simple, Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheree. A chimney is lucky and lucky can be. Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheroo. Good luck will rub off when I shake hands with you.
Now as the ladder of life has been strung, you may say a sweep's on the bottommost rung. Though he spends his time in the ashes and smoke, in this whole wide world there's no happier bloke.
Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheree. A chimney sweep's lucky as lucky can be. Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheroo. Good luck will rub off when I shake hands with you.
In our profession there's plenty of time when we embark on a perilous climb. Up where the smoke is all billowed and curled, twixt pavement and stars is a chimney sweep world.
Gables and rooftops become Taj Mahals, and blimey the chimneys are great Chinese walls. The pillars of Hercules loom left and right, the Sphinx, the Acropolis, call, what a sight.
Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheree. A chimney sweep's lucky as lucky can be. Chim chimney, chim chimney, chim chim cheroo. Good luck will rub off when I shake hands with you.
Or blow me a kiss, and that's lucky.
Just in time, I found you just in time. Before you came, my time was running low.
I was lost, the losing dice were tossed, my bridges all were crossed, nowhere to go.
Now you're here, and now I know just where I'm going. No more doubt or fear, I'm on my way. For love came just in time.
You found me just in time, and changed my lonely life as long.
In time.
You found me just in time. often wonder if you could be related to everyone with your last name.
Just think if you're a Lincoln, how you'd be congratulated if Honest Abe were someone you could claim.
To clear up any mystery, just check your family history.
Genealogy is the name of the game. Now some ancestors you'll find you want to hide,
but most of them will fill your heart with pride.
Oh, your family tree. Check your genealogy. Find who was who and how who came to be. On your family tree.
From the time the Isle of Britain came to be, I can proudly say there's been an Andrews tree.
Since the day the Emerald Isle came on the scene, it has always had a tree of Kelly green.
Now there was an Andrews at King Arthur's table, while another laid the great Atlantic cable.
Sure, they swear it was a Kelly who first kissed the Blarney Stone, but they're all so full of Blarney, if it's true, I've never known.
Now we've had tailors and physicians,
jesters and magicians.
Oh, every limb is simply laden with the blokes and blokesses.
We've had royalty and farmers,
obstetricians and embalmers.
We have run a gaudy gamut with our folks. You know, Julie, really you have a great-looking family tree.
Yes, I know I do. But so do you. I must say, I'd like to do a bit of pruning, though. For instance, great-Uncle Roy. Hi, Uncle Roy.
What's wrong with him?
Well, he was one of Robin Hood's band. He was an awful man.
Well, why? They stole from the rich and gave to the poor.
Yeah, but then he stole it back from the poor and kept it.
Well, he wasn't as bad as my Uncle Sean. My Uncle Sean was a pirate.
But that's romantic.
Romantic?
Mm-hmm.
Uncle Sean! Oh, my gosh, he hit someone in your tree.
It's just my great aunt Gertrude. She was warming up. She was an opera star, you know. She'll manage. She does it all the time. Jean, who's that marvelous-looking man?
Why, that's my great-great-great-great-great-grandfather.
Well, he looks nice.
I said he was great. Me great, 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 great grandfather, Seamus was his name. He invented the Irish jig, or so the Kellys claim.
Well, now, we've a couple of pipers in the Andrews clan, and they'd be happy to pipe a tune for a great old Irish man.
Sure, you want to know how I invented the Irish jig?
In Paddy's bar, 100 hooligans started up a fight. But me and Paddy, we licked them, though it took us half the night. With whiskey bottles and beer bottles, we fought them till the morn. And stepping over the broken glass, the Irish jig was born. Stepping over the broken glass, the Irish jig was born. And talent in the family died out with me.
Oh, your family tree,
your family tree. tree. Check your genealogy, find who is who and how who came to be on your family tree.
Dancers and musicians most surely have their charms,
but the ones the family brags about are the gallant men-at-arms.
Now, we had a knight who loved to joust and use the battering ram a lot.
The battering ram a lot?
Yes, Jean, you'll never guess. My knight had his day...
in Camelot.
Oh, you guessed. Camelot! It sounds a bit bizarre, but in Camelot, that's how conditions are. In short, there's simply not a more congenial spot for happy ever aftering than here in Camelot.
I think your sir was a her.
In that outfit, we never really could find out.
I had a hero in my family once. He was a musketeer. Mm-hmm. Oh, no mistaking a man then.
Oh, which one's he?
He's the one back there with the satin pants, the velvet blouse, the long hair, and the feathers in his hat. Temper.
Jean, of all your ancestors, is there one you would most like to have been?
Are you kidding? I've always wanted to be him.
Who?
William the Wizard, the greatest court magician of all time.
Jean, don't wish it on yourself. It's no fun being a wizard. No fun at all. Get down. You see, all that hocus pocus, it finally catches up with you. I worked for years trying to turn lead into gold. I finally did it. That year, gold was out, lead was in. What's that up there? What? Get out of here, Wizard! I tell you, you want trouble if you... Oh, yeah. Hey, Hawkins! Give your handkerchief, will you? Well, that's for the birds. Take that. I need a drink. I'm going to... Porcus, I want a drink. Hey, Porcus, I need some water. You're fired! That kind of fuck. Oh, I tell you, me nerves are shot. They're really shot. I have to do everything myself. Here's a portion I'm having, and here's for you. Oh, dear. No, I've done it, Gene.
Oh, dear, he's gone. He's really gone.
Don't worry, I'll fix it.
Hey, that was marvelous.
That runs in the family.
Oh. Well, I guess it does. Thank you.
Say, Julie,
mm-hmm.
Who is that lady?
Poor Aunt Jane, prim and plain. Men often tarried, but never married. Poor Aunt Jane, poor Aunt Jane.
Same with him, Uncle Jim. Romance eluded him, nobody suited him. Uncle Jim, Uncle Jim.
Poor Aunt Jane, prim and plain. Then often tarried, but never married.
Romance eluded him, nobody suited him.
Poor Aunt Jane, poor Aunt Jane, poor Aunt Jane.
Uncle Jim,
poor Aunt Jane. You know, it's sad they couldn't have gotten together. They might have liked each other.
Say, Julie, who's your favorite ancestor?
Oh, without any doubt at all, my great aunt Bertie. She was the toast of the music halls at the turn of the century. See ya?
Hi, Aunt Bertie.
Oh, Jean, you're a fellow. You're a funny little guy. I'm really wild about you. I just can't tell you why. There must be some good reason that makes me feel this way. 'Cause every time I look at you, I want to stand and say, ho ho, it's men like you make women like me go crazy over men like you. You know it isn't because you'd do me wrong if you could. It's not for what you got, 'cause what you have got is good. It's just because when we're alone, sweetheart, I never know just what you'll do. Now I know you've been a soldier and you love to fight, so I'll arrange a battle for you every night. Oh, it's men like you make women like me go crazy over men like you. You know it's men like you make women like me go crazy over men like you. You know the first time I saw you, I certainly fell, 'cause you had all the answers and the questions as well. Oh, I had a lot of boyfriends in my time, but only for a day or two. Now, although you're rather skinny, everything is fine. If I can't sit on your knee, then you'll sit on mine. Oh, it's men like you make women like me go crazy over men like you. Oh, here we go, boys.
To me, you're only once upon this earth, so have yourself a spree. A spree is what I'm having, and no matter what the price, I'm having myself a whirl of a time following his advice.
Singing a bell-bottom trousers, coats of navy blue, jigging in the rigging like his daddy used to do.
All ashore that's going ashore, there's sailors on the town. I'm walking off with any freight that isn't back now.
Singing a bell-bottom trousers, coats of navy blue.
I'll climb the rigging like my daddy used to do.
Thank you. she'll pick a few and serve them personally. Julie, 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 Juliology. Julie, 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 Juliology.
Thank you.
ever having more fun doing a show.
And I've never been a happier guest. Even the rehearsals were fun.
Yeah, they were. They really were fun. Gene had us all playing a tapping game. I don't know what the name of it is.
Well, I don't think it has a name. It's kid's game.
It's the one where you tap a song with your knuckles or a pencil or whatever, and the others have to guess what the song is.
She's the champ.
Well, of course. But when you do it with Gene, he taps it with his feet, and it's really quite fun. See if you can guess one. Do one. Can you guess what that is? Do it again.
Right.
Right, Rule Britannia. It's a lovely song.
You do one.
All right.
Easy. By the sea, by the sea, by the beautiful sea.
You and me,
oh, how happy we'll be.
Oh, the water's cold.
No, I don't know what to do.
All right.
Now, you all think that that's Yankee Doodle again.
Sounds like it, doesn't it? But it's not.
Afraid to speak when I was just a lad.
Yes?
My father gave my nose a tweak and told me I was bad.
But then one day he learned a word that saved his aching nose, the biggest word you ever heard, and this is how it goes.
Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious. Supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Everywhere I went, mm-hmm. I'd use my word and all would say, there goes a clever gent.
Now, when dukes and maharajas pass the time of day with me, I say this special word and then they ask me out to tea.
Oh, supercalifragilisticexpialidocious, even though the sound of it is something quite atrocious, if you say it loud enough, you'll always sound precocious.
The thing I enjoyed most in the show was teaching Julie some old-fashioned hoofing.
Oh, that was the best fun in the world.
Yum tugga dum dum dum.
My favorite.
Now we'll try it setting up.
Just about used itself up. And before it's completely gone, I'd like to thank Gene Kelly and the Christy Minstrels and you for sharing it with me until you and I can get together again. Should old acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind? Should old acquaintance be forgot? And days of old lang syne, for old lang syne, my dear, for old lang syne.
And here's a hand, my trusty friend, and here's a hand of mine. We'll take a cup of kindness yet for Auld Lang Syne. For Auld Lang Syne.
Good night.
The Julie Andrews Show was brought to you by